wanna go back to my little grass shack in Kealakekua, Hawaii. I wanna be with all the Connies and Wahinis that I used to know. I can hear the old guitars a-playing on the beach at Ho'onaunau. I can hear the old Hawaiian saying, E komo mai no ka ua ika hale vela kaha. It won't be long till my ship will be sailing back to Kona. It's a grand old place that's always fair to see. I'm just a little Hawaiian and a homesick island boy. I wanna go back to my fishing point. I wanna go back to my little grass shack in Kealakekua, Hawaii, where the humu humu nuku nuku apua go swimming by. Where the humu humu nuku nuku apua go swimming by. I wanna go back to my little grass shack in Kealakekua, Hawaii. I wanna be with all the Connies and Wahinis that I used to know long ago. I can hear the old guitars a-playing on the beach at Ho'onaunau. I can hear the old Hawaiian saying, E komo mai no ka ua I ka hale vela kaha. It won't be long till my ship will be sailing back to Kona. It's a grand old place that's always fair to see. I'm just a little Hawaiian and a homesick island boy. I wanna go back to my fishing point. I wanna go back to my little grass shack in Kealakekua, Hawaii, where the humu humu nuku nuku apua go swimming by. Where the humu humu nuku nuku apua go swimming by.
I can't take a shower.
Oh!
Now listen here, little Miss Betty Wall. Can't you see that I am working here? I promise you, you won't miss your precious little shower.
Well, listen here, Mr. Little Buzzard Wall. Somebody's gonna be sleeping by theirself tonight, and I can tell you something, mister, it ain't gonna be me.
You popped my beach recliner! You know, it only cost me a small fortune, Betty! And you popped my beach recliner!
You popped my beach recliner! You know, I should have just let you electrocute yourself, see if that got you any closer to your Hawaiian getaway.
Visualize before you can realize, Betty. How many times I gotta tell you? You've got to believe it to achieve it.
Oh, well, thank you, Tony Robbins, for that inspirational horseshit. But you can't keep wasting water and our lives trying to find the answer to skin cancer or whatever you're trying to do with that stuff on your nose.
Now, hold on just one minute now, baby. We can't quit now. I mean, any minute we're going to get the money we need to start production on Camo, and then it's going to be Honolulu, here we come.
More like a bankruptcy, here we go.
Oh, like Publishers Clearinghouse is gonna come up here right now because you subscribe to every magazine in the entire free world? That's what's bankrupting us.
Out here right now.
You know it makes Miss Betty sad. You're such a naughty boy with your naughty toy. You haven't forgotten about tonight, have you, baby?
Oh, I haven't forgotten about tonight.
That's good, because neither have I.
What's my name, baby?
Buzzard Ball.
What's my name, baby?
Steve McGarrett.
Oh! Get over here! All right, here we go now, baby! You think my hair would look good like McGarrett's?
I think you're losing your mind. That's what I think.
Is that what you think?
Yes, I do.
You know what I think? I think that you need a buzzard sausage sandwich smothered in underwear.
Baby, I think you might be right.
Oh, Buzz! Oh, oh, so soon, Buzz!
Are you close, baby?
Oh, sorta.
Well, you know the buzzard can go on that, baby. You know that.
I know, love, muffin, but we shouldn't got such a late start.
Well, I can't help it. Your biological clock and prime time don't always coincide now, baby, can I?
Oh, that feels good, Buzz, right there.
Yeah?
Oh, yes, yes.
Oh, now I'm close.
How close?
Oh, now I'm real close, baby.
Well, how much time, Buzz?
Oh, don't talk about time now, baby, when the buzzard's starting to fly.
We're going to get one this time, Buzz. We're going to get one this time.
Must love you. Oh, hand me my shorts, would you, honey?
Okay,
babe. Is it time yet?
Nope. Just 5 more minutes, baby.
You sure this is gonna work?
Bob said his cousin tried it and they got pregnant lickety split.
You know, there is such a thing called adoption, honey.
Don't mention that word in this house, Betty Wall. How many times I gotta tell you? If the buzzard can't shoot bullets, we ain't gonna hunt.
Nobody said this was y'all fault. Where you going, baby? Buzz? 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 Buzz!
Thank you. you'd like to take the grand tour of a lonely house that once was home, sweet home. I have nothing.
Where you headed?
Cactus Gulch.
Hop in.
Just some things that I will tell you.
I can only take you to the third stop.
Well, you're a nice fella.
You've been on the road a while, ain't you?
Yep.
Yeah. So what you doing in Cactus Gulch is deader than a desert mackerel down there.
Gotta take care of my family.
Yeah. Well, it's a small town. I probably know your family.
I doubt it. They're recluses.
Recluses? What's that?
They're private. What kind of gas mileage does this thing get?
Well, I don't know, about maybe 10, 12 miles to a gallon, I'd say.
You can let me out here.
Where?
Anywhere.
Whatever you say. Hope it wasn't nothing I said.
What'd you say your shirt size was?
I didn't.
Doing this to me?
I don't know. I guess I just like watching people suffer.
Please. My son needs me.
That is the biggest pumpkin.
Ready, Juan?
Yes. Big, huge, enormous pumpkin segment. Take one.
Bob, right this way, please. You just stand over here and tell us about your gourd.
Pumpkin.
Good morning, Cactus Gulch. We're here this morning with Bob Brunswick, his wife, Dolly, who's around here somewhere.
Dolly!
Yeah!
Hey, come on, get up here. Get the lead out, honey. We're rolling here.
Bob, why don't you tell us a little bit about your pride and joy there?
Well, we nicknamed this little beauty Tiny. Tiny, you're going to make me laugh now. Tiny started out as a tiny little pumpkin seed that we planted after some hooligans smashed our Halloween pumpkin on our front porch last October.
Yeah, and it took us 2 days to get that goo off the park swing.
The pumpkin, Bob, please.
Well, anyway, we planted the sucker and looked after it like we do all our other vegetables, and started responding.
Well, okay then. Tell you what, Bob. Why don't we do what you were suggesting before we went on the air? Oh, how about that?
No, no, I didn't mean literally, you know, riding it. I meant, you know, like figure of speech.
Then I could get the whole dog.
Well, I know, honey, but you
come
know.
Come on. Come
oh,
on.
Come on, Bob. Come on, Bob.
Yeah, giddy up, Tiny. Come on, you big old gorg.
Well, that's all we have time for. So until next time, this is Maya Gundinger saying, we've got it good in Cactus Gulch. And cut.
Oh. Honey, I feel stupid.
Not getting any pumpkin pie. Get off that thing.
I'm stuck in a one-horse town doing stories about giant pumpkins.
We didn't let the rain stop us from surprising our new millionaire.
Let's go. Is Joyce here? We're the Prize Patrol from Publishers Clearing.
Oh, my. I don't believe it.
You just won $1 million.
I watch it on TV, and I know those people always look like they're really surprised. I just don't know what to say. I think I'm going to faint.
She promised to share it with her friends and relatives.
We're the Prize Patrol from Publishers Clearinghouse, and we could surprise you next.
$10 million. Shit.
Baby, been working on the brochure for Camo and ordering it by.
Like
ready?
The
all right, then.
So the days of our lives.
You all right? What's the matter?
No, nothing. It's fine. It's just the onions.
Oh, you really need to wash them first, babe.
I did.
Oh. Okay, then.
This
now.
This is McDonald Carey, and these are the days of our lives.
Camo is ready to revolutionize the battle against skin cancer caused by overexposure to the sun. By completely camouflaging the sun from your skin, Camo is unlike any other sunscreen product on the market. It gives you a sun protection factor of over 150. That's right, over 150, guaranteed. Not only that, Camo is created from the finest all-natural ingredients. No artificial colors, no artificial chemicals, no artificial nothing, no way, no how. Just 100% pure desert. So if you're thinking about cooking, slap on some Camo. I'm still working on the ending, but what do you think?
Well, that's great, Buzz. Really.
Isn't it? And the colors are going to get the kids so excited, and we're going to get money for that production, and before you know it's going to be Honolulu, here we come.
You really think so?
I know so, baby. Visualize, visualize. I'm certain of it now. Oh, what's the matter, sweetheart? Oh, baby. It's not the onions, is it?
Buzz, could we just make love again one more time?
Right now, I gotta do some product testing, honey.
Oh, right now, right here. Nothing fancy, no gravity boots. Just hold me, please.
Baby, that's what I was trying
oh,
to tell you.
Shit.
That there's Bob and Dolly.
Oh,
we have to do some
God.
Product testing up on the hill at high noon with virgin skin.
Oh, Buzz, tell them to come back in an hour.
Baby, I can't.
Yes, you can.
Baby, they fired two of the meat flippers at Cactus Burger. That means Bob only has half a day off now.
Oh, Buzz, just kiss me.
Betty!
Buzzard!
Come on, let's go!
Coming!
He's only got a 3-foot house. Where's he coming from?
Later.
Please,
later.
Buddy,
later.
Please, don't leave me here, please. I really need
later.
You right now.
Oh. Hey, Buckaroo!
Hey!
Bob and Dolly, how you doing? Clyde?
Howdy, Buzz. Is there a place where I can change?
Sure.
Where's Betty?
Oh, right here. Hi, how y'all doing?
Did you just wake up, girl?
No, I've been chopping vegetables again.
Uh-huh.
You need to wipe your face, baby. Do I see there you got yourself a promotion, Bob?
I'm just so proud of him, I can bust.
Stop that.
Congratulations, that's great.
Buzz, where can I change?
Oh, right in the back, Clyde.
Come on, Clyde, you know better than to ask. Get in there. Big boy.
You know, Bob and me, we hardly ever chop vegetables in the daytime anymore now.
Oh, darling.
What are you talking about? Once we harvest old Tiny, we're gonna be chopping vegetables day and night.
Yeah, one can only dream.
So sorry we was late. Speaking of vegetables, though, you know our pumpkin in the backyard?
Yeah, you know that woman's got that cable program, Eye on Cactus Gulch? Well, she kept a pestering me. Well, you used to know her pretty well there, didn't you, Buzzard?
Yeah.
Well, what do you say we get a move on now, huh?
So, you used to know my Gundinger, did you?
Huh. It was a long time ago, baby. Now, let me get these celebrities up on the hill, slap some slap some camo on them. I'll come back down. We'll finish that lunch. What do you say?
You know, if me or Dolly get burned, we're going to sue you for everything you got.
And you do realize, Bob, that that's going to get you exactly what you got now. Not a penny.
Well, that's real funny, Buzz.
All right, now. Hey, Clyde!
Meet us up on the hill, all right? And light a match when you're done.
I'm back in baby's arms. How I miss those loving arms. I'm back.
Okay, now I guess we're cooking with camo. Or I guess we're not cooking because of camo.
How long we been out here?
Oh, just a few minutes, Bob.
It's hotter than a sick woman.
What is it, about 120 degrees out here today?
I'm just fine, Buzz.
See, now that's the spirit, Clyde. Y'all just keep the camo on. You're not gonna have any problems at all, I promise. See you in a while.
Hey, now you're not gonna go off and leave us all up here alone now. Come on.
Yeah, when'll we know when to turn over?
The sun's harmful rays are completely blocked. Roll over when you feel like it. And if you like, I'll put some camo on your back.
I don't think so.
I'll give it a rest, Bob.
All right, then. Seems to me Clyde has the whole situation under control. So, now, I'm gonna head back to the house. I'll come back in a few minutes, all right?
Hey, no, Buzz. Now, wait. Hey, hold on there, little buckaroo. I cannot believe I agreed to this.
Oh, now, Bob.
You know how easy I blistered.
What you got there?
From the Plantail Corporation.
Oh, what's it say? Visualize Buzzard Wall. We regret to inform you that we have no funding available for your product at this time. No.
Looks like bankruptcy. Here we go.
Baby, this can't be happening.
It is happening, Buzz. It has been happening for a long time now. And you're the only one that doesn't seem to be able to see it.
What the hell's that supposed to mean?
I want a real life, Buzz. I'm so tired of being poor, waiting for somebody to finance your dreams.
Our dreams, baby?
Yes, our dreams, Buzz, but we don't live in a world where dreams put food on the table.
Eddie, listen.
I mean, look at me, Buzz. I get so crazy and scared. I start depending on the damn lottery to make ends meet.
You said you believed in me.
It isn't just about you, Buzz. It's about us. It's about our kids having a choice. I mean, isn't it time you start thinking about getting a real job?
I have worked my ass off trying to make a difference in this world, Betty. Now we get one lousy setback and you're all, well, isn't it time to get a real job?
This is not just one lousy setback, Buzz. What happens every time? What about that harebrained pyramid scheme selling herbal laxatives? What was that about?
That was not a laxative. That was an internal cleanser.
Whatever, Buzz, it's like we get shot down and then you find something else and then we get shot down again. I am so tired of it, Buzz. I need a little bit of time to think, all right? I need to get out.
Where are you going?
Just out.
think you got yourself a winner here, big fella.
Hey, don't go scaring me like that.
Well, party's over, folks.
Huh?
Yes, sir. No more blisters for Bob Brunswick. I think you got it right this time, boy.
Did you hear me, Bob? I said time's up. I gotta get a job.
What's wrong?
Look, basically, that corporation I was telling you about, I just heard word that they're not gonna give me no financing on camo, all right? They sent me a letter. End of story.
Oh, that's terrible, Buzz. Where's Betty?
She said she needed to go out for a while.
Look, boys, I think we need to give Buzz just a little bit of privacy. Let's go now.
Yeah.
Oh, come on, Bobby. Get your bag.
I've never felt so free.
Now, Buzz, don't you worry. Everything's gonna be all right.
It'll all work out, Buckaroo.
You know, sometimes you plant a tiny pumpkin seed and next thing you know, got yourself a whopper.
Thanks, I'll keep that in mind, Bob.
You tell Betty I'll call her later.
Thanks again, y'all. I couldn't have done it without you.
Mr. Sand. You've made me smile. When you're ready, come to me.
I feel maybe it was a stupid dream after all.
Buzzard Wall! I am King Kamehameha the Great, ancient ruler of the Hawaiian Islands. I have come to tell you that life is about making the right choice, Buzzard Wall. You are about to begin a journey. The path will be difficult. The struggle will be hard. The temptation will be great. But if you pass these tests, the meaning of your life will unfold under the Hula Moon.
Oh my God. King! King Kamehameha! What am I supposed to do now? How will I know?
To her parents. And in another gruesome tragedy, police report that 35-year-old corrections guard Buddy Robles was brutally murdered in a prison breakout yesterday when he was shot to death by an inmate. A second inmate was killed by guards. The suspected killer, 36-year-old Turk Dixon, escaped and is still at large. Police believe Dixon to be criminally insane and warn that he is armed and extremely dangerous. They are also asking anyone who has seen this man or has any information to contact them at 555-555.
That shit at the same time.
And now, turning to
easy.
The
this is the kind of story I'd love to cover.
Hey, have you seen the abducted alien file?
Yeah, it's somewhere up there.
Ah, here it is. I'm out of here.
Where are you off to?
Nogales, to do a little dancing for the weekend. By the way, I forgot. The boss said that an out-of-town crew was coming in to shoot a commercial today, and that he got them to agree to drop off a rough copy in case you want to follow up on it afterwards.
Oh, joy.
This?
One.
What?
Well, what do you think?
Think of what?
My new promo outfit.
Oh. Well, I think it's is very pink to me.
Pink.
La 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 la, boo boo, body too. I wanna meet you, Baba. La 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 la. My husband is a slob. Shut the damn door, Buzzard. Shut the damn door. Think he was raising Bond.
Must be Betty.
How the hell did you get in my house?
Back door was open.
Where's my husband?
I guess old brother Buzz doesn't tell you any more than he tells me.
Y'all his brother?
Turk Dixon, short for turkey. I never will forgive Mama for naming us after those two particular birds.
Our last name's Wall, not Dixon.
We'd had different fathers. Mama's on husband number 6 even as we speak.
Well, Buzz never has said too much about his family.
Listen, I'm real sorry if I scared you. I should have spoke up right when you walked in. I suppose I should have waited outside, but I was real dirty and the door was open. I just figured I'd clean up before I met me a beautiful woman.
How do you know about me?
Family correspondence. And that is just what I've done. Met me a beautiful woman. My company car conked out a few miles back. I don't know how many miles, but it was on the other side of town.
Oh, that's kind of weird, because I was just in town, and I didn't see it.
Were you on the far side of town?
No, I sure wouldn't.
That's why you didn't see it. Sure wish I'd known you were in town, though. It saved me a hell of a sunburn.
Oh, shit. It's too bad you didn't have any camo.
Huh?
Camo is something my husband, Buzz, makes. It protects you from the sun. It's real good.
That's good, not getting burned. Buzz is always up to something.
Well, since you are family and all, I guess I ought to show you around the hacienda.
I'd like that quite a bit.
Well, the kitchen, the living room, and the bedroom. what kind of company do you work for?
Huh?
Well, it must be nice getting a company car.
Oh, I work for the state.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, government work. Very boring, really.
Hey!
Maybe
something happened today? I can't wait to tell you about it.
Buzzard, I want you to tell me right now why you have never introduced me to this handsome, successful brother of yours. Buzz?
Hello, Buzzard. I missed you. It's been, what, 15 years?
You're wearing my robe. How'd you get my robe?
How'd he get your robe? Oh, he was all hot and sweaty because he'd left his company car across town. Anyway, you left the door open as usual. He walks in, washes up, sits down, scares the living shit out of me, and then introduced himself, right?
That's pretty much it. That was a limp dick hello, Buzzard. Aren't you glad to see your own family?
Language, Dirk.
Pardon me.
Oh, it's all right.
So, what's a happy occasion brings your sorry ass to our humble abode?
Watch your language, Buzz.
Honey, did something happen while you were gone?
I'll tell you later, baby.
Okay.
Don't let me interrupt anything.
No, you're not. He never tells me anything anyway, remember? Well, why don't I get us all something to drink? You want something to drink? Drink?
How long you staying?
Just till tonight.
In that case, have a seat. Yeah, baby, I could use a drink.
Coming up.
Why don't you get me one of them beers I've been saving?
Your beer ain't here, honey. You must have drunk it.
Did you check behind the iced tea?
Yes, I looked behind the iced tea, Buzz.
I'll have some iced tea, baby. Now, I'll take you over to your car later if that's what you want. But after that, I'd like you out of here by tonight.
Geez, Buzz, he's your brother. Lighten up.
Sweetie, I'd appreciate it if you just stay out of this.
Sweetie, I'd appreciate you not using that tone of voice with me.
Got a damn fine woman there, Buzz.
Yep.
Not only is she beautiful, but she knows how to let bygones be bygones. I mean, there I went and scared the, what'd you call it?
Living shit.
Out of you, and 10 minutes later, she served me drinks like I was a bygone president. Tell you what, if you were my own little brother, I'd be doing just about anything I could to stay here every night.
You hitting on my wife now, Turk?
Oh, of course not. He's just kidding. Sit down. My goodness. Oh, silly.
Well, Betty, Buzz has a right to be a little leery of me. I was, in my younger years, what they call wild and crazy, to say the least.
He's got himself a government job. I think that's wonderful.
Tell me something, Turk. How does a convicted felon get himself a cushy gig with Uncle Sam?
Convicted felon?
Well, Buzz, they normally don't like us to talk about this. But as you know, the U.S.-Mexican border is the site of a lot of drug smuggling activity. Sometimes the government feels they need a flunky, such as myself, someone they could hold something over on to do the dirty work for them.
Oh, you went to jail?
I did my time. And most people have forgiven me, Buzz.
Most people would have believed that story you just told, too.
Well, enough about me. I want to hear about you and how you've turned the world upside down, saving mankind from burning up, Buzz. You must have managed to squirrel away quite a little nest egg by now.
Not hardly.
Betty?
Well, what do you want me to say, Buzz? We just got a notice telling Buzz he wasn't going to get any financing for his product.
Betty?
We haven't really decided what we're going to do yet, but, you know.
Baby, why don't you just tell the whole world, huh?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Now, when I was up testing with the camo today, I told Bob and Dolly and Clyde that I was going to stop all production and get myself a real job. You happy now?
Oh, honey, that is so sweet.
Oh, well, I'm sure you'll come up with something. Now, if you'll all excuse me, I'm going to get changed. I don't want to be parading around here naked with Betty around and all.
Isn't this great? Your brother and all, great, isn't it?
You notice if anything was missing?
Buzz, how can you say that? He could probably get you on with some government research program.
You out of your mind?
Did you not just say, Buzz, that you were going to think about getting a real job?
Sweetheart, Turk is not going to give me a job.
Buzz, the gods close a door, then open a window.
Why did you just use that phrase?
What phrase?
The gods. Betty, if I tell you something, you promise not to laugh.
May I promise? Get it out.
I think that I saw God.
Oh, boy.
Not the God, but, well, a God. The God of Hawaii. Baby, today I saw King Kamehameha, ruler of the Hawaiian Islands. He came to me. He told me that the whole meaning of my life was gonna unfold under the hula moon.
Now, honey, King Kamehameha, the ruler of the Hawaiian Islands, he doesn't live near a trailer in the desert.
Don't patronize me, Betty. I know what I saw.
Just hand me the phone, but we'll discuss this later.
Are you a member of Triple A?
Triple what?
The Auto Club.
Fuck no.
Hey, you don't gotta go talking like that now.
You know, this shithole of the fucking trailer is starting to feel a whole lot like a goddamn interrogation room. Did it ever occur to somebody's pea-brained fucking mind that I don't need a fucking Auto Club card when I travel?
What are you getting so riled about all of a sudden?
Stop asking me so many goddamn fucking questions!
Turk, put the gun down, all right?
I got you! Yes, sir. That approach does tend to scare the fucking shit out of those wetback drug lords.
Jesus H. Christ, you son of a bitch!
Did you shit your britches there, brother? Hey, listen, I like to have a little fun every now and then, that's all. Takes the pressure off. You understand that, don't you, Betty? It was just a joke.
Well, it wasn't funny.
I may have been too quick to judge your wife there, saying all those good things about her. She's a bit of a bitch, as it turns out. Can't take a fucking joke.
You leave her out of this.
But then again, it's pretty hard to fucking laugh. Stuck here in this shithole, with a fucking white trash of a husband who's so fucking smart, he's pretty much goddamn good for nothing.
You apologize for that.
Oh, I'll apologize, asshole, when you apologize to me.
For what?
For treating me like I wasn't even your goddamn family. That's what for.
What do you want from me?
I want you to tell me you love me, Buzz. That's what I want.
I love you, Turk.
Do you mean that, Betty?
He don't say it unless he means it.
Well, if you love me, then how about slide me a little, a little money. Just tide me over money till I get my next paycheck. How about that?
This here's $65, and it's all we got. Now you take it and get the hell out of here. Now you walk to get your gas. That's right, get the hell out of here. I don't want you to ever come back here again, you understand me? Mama was right about you. You've been nothing but a freeloading scavenger ever since we were kids, and you ain't changed a bit. Now get your butt up and get out. And, one other thing. Apologize to my wife.
Buzz.
You brain dead motherfuckers. People like you make me sick. You want some of this? Do you? Well, come on. This is your last chance. You never could you? Should have stayed down. Where's your extension cord?
I'm okay. Oh, you big man!
Shut the fuck up. I wasn't kidding about that money.
Buzz is telling the truth. That's all the money we have. Couldn't the government just loan it to you?
You're dumber than dirt, aren't you, Betty?
Don't hurt him, please.
All right. I'll tell you what we're gonna do. Have a little fun.
Don't you touch her!
Shut the fuck up! Tell you what we gonna do. Since you don't have any money, Buzz, I'm gonna I'm gonna have my way with your wife here. And you're gonna stay put. You're gonna stay put and shut the fuck up, or I'll kill her. And you're gonna enjoy it. And you're gonna make me fucking believe it. Because if you don't, I'm gonna kill your fucking husband, you got me? But if everything goes well, I just take your fucking car. Call it even. Let that be an added incentive.
Oh, baby.
It's all right, Buzz. It's okay.
Oh, it's gonna be so much fun. I wasn't gonna do this. John forced me into it. By the time they find your rotted carcasses, I'll be sipping a margarita across the border. You gotta be shitting me.
Hello.
Get up. All right, now listen to me carefully. If you be a good girl, wipe the tears away, the blood off your nose, you behave, put a big smile on your face, I'll leave you guys alone.
Well, too bad they're not home. They sure look like they could use the money.
Happy now. Go on, answer the door.
Burn. Burn.
Shut your mouth!
The Home Office is not going to be happy, Kim.
Wait! Don't leave! We're here! We're here! Come on up!
Are you Mrs. Betty Jean Wall of Cactus Gulch?
Yes, I am!
Well, how would you like a check for $10,000?
Oh! Yeah! Did you hear that? $10,000?
Thousand? That's right, Betty. Publishers Clearinghouse has a new program honoring all those who have entered our contest time after time without ever winning.
Not million?
Don't fuck it up, Betty.
Their names are put into a special drawing, and from those special lucky loser contestants, a name is drawn to win $10,000!
Isn't that great?
Just take the money and make him leave.
Is your husband in there?
Yeah, get him out here!
Nah, he's kind of tied up right now.
Oh, but I'm sure he wants to see this big check for $10,000!
Yes, maybe he would. I'll just take it inside and give it to him.
Oh, absolutely not. One of the conditions of receiving payment is that the family consents to do an on-camera commercial. So get his butt out here.
Well, I don't know if I can right now.
Oh, don't mind him. It's just the heat. Well, Betty, what do you say?
Don't you want the money? Don't you need it?
Well, yes, I do need the money, yes.
Then get his lazy ass to the door in under a minute, or you can kiss this check goodbye.
Okay. Honey, it's the only way we're gonna get the money.
Don't give me and my wife some money, huh?
He is just testing our new product, Camo. It's got a SPF factor of over 150. All natural ingredients, nothing archaeological. It's gonna revolutionate the industry.
Honey, that's enough. I got work to do. Let's get this show on the road.
I'm sorry. What was your name, Mr. Wall?
Turk.
Buzz. Honey, you know they don't know my nickname.
Yeah, I forgot.
Buzz is a lot easier to remember anyway.
Well, Buzz, if you and Betty could just stand together in the doorway and hold this, and when Marvin says, action, just start acting crazy because you just won all this money. Did you wipe his face?
No.
Yeah.
No, looks great.
Well, what are we supposed to do with this?
Well, that's just for show, Buzz. Show, Buzz. I like that. Anyway, with amounts this small, we give you a check that you can deposit on the spot.
And where would that check be?
Oh, well, you'll get it as soon as we do this, all right?
All right, now, high energy. Betty, not so stiff. Relax, like your husband. Okay, on 5, 4, 3, 2, and action!
Buzz, would you take a look at this big old check for $1,000,000? It's the kind of money we've been dreaming about. Thank you, Publishers Clear and Hutz. Thank you, thank you. It's barely enough to live on, but we'll take it anyway. Thank you.
Shut up, honey. Give me a kiss.
Terrific! Okay.
Yeah, where's that check at?
Oh, right here. Just sign here. Okay, congratulations again.
Yes, congratulations.
When's that tape gonna air?
Well, the local news will get a rough copy today, and if they want a story, it usually takes them a couple of weeks.
Good. Tell them not to come any sooner. We'll go out and buy some stuff first.
Are you sure you don't want to come in for a moment?
No, they don't want to come in.
Are you sure? No?
I should have shot them before they drove off. I didn't do bad as old Buzz.
No, did I?
All right, here's the deal. She's coming with me, Buzz.
Oh, come on, Turk.
Shut the fuck up! Now, she's coming with me, and if you try to call the cops or you try to come after us, I'm gonna blow her pretty little fucking face off, you hear me? But if you're a good boy and you stay put, when I get across the border, you'll get a phone call to let you know where you can come pick her up. Understand me, Buzz? Do you understand me?
Hey, Maya, station manager wanted me to get this to you right away. Some people from the Publishers Clearinghouse just dropped this off.
Well, thank you, Chuck.
Yeah.
It's gonna be fine, okay? It's gonna be fine.
I love you, baby.
Oh, isn't that sweet? That's a good look for you, Buzz. Come on. Honey, that's enough. I got work to do. Let's get this show on the road.
I'm sorry. What was your name, Mr. Wall?
Turk.
Buzzard Wall? That's not Buzzard Wall. That's...
I'm sorry. What was your name, Mr. Wall? Turk.
Wall, Buzzard. Come on.
Thank you.
quite so rough.
What a dump.
Buzz! Are you okay? What happened?
King Kamehameha, he said, struggle hard and you'll get a chance.
Buzz?
And then Turk said, if you chase us, I'll kill her.
Kill who?
He said he's gonna kill Betty. That's who do you think?
Where is Betty?
Please don't kill Betty.
Do you still love me, bud?
How you doing, buddy? Don't you still love me?
Maya Gundinger.
Maya?
Uh-huh.
Maya Gundinger?
Yes, Buzz.
Shit, could you untie me, please?
Oh, my God, of course. I'm sorry, Buzz.
Hurry up!
Coming, Buzz.
Shit, Ma. Hurry up! Hurry!
I am hurrying!
Just stay, I'm over here. What the hell are you doing
okay?
Here?
Look, I'll explain later. Buzz, wait a minute. The more important question is, Buzz, what happened here today?
I'll explain that to you later. Right now. Damn it, Maya, get that thing out of my face. Right now, I need to borrow your car.
Buzz, right now, you need to see a doctor.
I don't need to see a doctor. I need to go find Betty, all right?
Okay. Where is Betty?
Shut up and get the damn car, Betty.
Asshole. Jeez, Buzz, you gotta get that taken care of.
Keep telling me what to do, Maya, all right? You always did that.
Now, Buzz, don't you go off half-cocked without telling me anything. Ow. Like you always did.
Ah! Give me your car, damn it!
I'll give you the car, damn it! But you've got to take me with you. I just want to help you, Buzz.
Oh, that was very good, Maya Gundinger. You almost got me there. You'll help me if I'll take you with me, right? Always the opportunist, aren't you, Maya?
Oh!
Maya, I would sooner have you kick a fork in my eye than take you with me. And then he just grabbed her and took off.
Wow. That is some story. How can you be sure they took this road?
I can't. But he said he was going to Mexico, and this is the straightest route without drawing a lot of attention.
You sure we shouldn't call the police?
No, not yet. Now, here's the plan. Maya, what the hell are you doing?
Well, what do you think I'm doing?
Jesus Christ, don't you have a sensitive bone in your body? Get that damn thing out of my face!
Oh, come on, Buzz. Look, I've stumbled onto the story that's going to change my life. I mean, think about this. Man's wife, stolen by brother after violent struggle. Man decides to go after him. Alone. Bloody carnage ensues.
You are sick!
Oh, look, I am sorry, Buzz, but this is just too good to pass up!
No! No! You are really sick, Maya! That's the only reason you came along, isn't it? Just so you could get your juicy little story.
That's not fair. That's not fair! Who untied your ass back at the trailer, huh? If it wasn't for me, your wife would be your sister-in-law before you caught up to her.
You leave her out of this!
Oh, I wish I could! But you had to drop me like a hot rock and take up with her before we had a chance to work things out.
Ah! That was a long time ago, Maya, and none of that would have happened if you hadn't decided that you needed a man with money.
Mario meant nothing to me. He was old enough to be my father!
Exactly!
Oh, please, Buzz, when we were dating, you were living out of your car! Your wife must be thrilled with the upgrade.
I'm sorry, is that a dick in your pants? Or are you just glad to see me?
That's cute, Buzz. That is real cute.
For your information, Betty loves me for who I am. So don't even try to suggest otherwise, all right?
Okay.
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 Okay. Just shut up and drive.
Buzz ain't gonna let you get away with this. He's gonna find us, I can feel it.
You'll grow to love me. All women do, sooner or later.
I thought you gonna let me go.
I lied.
A rendezvous with a brutal murderer and his kidnapped victim. No, and his kidnapped prey.
Do you really have to keep doing that?
Huh? Oh, I'm sorry. Look, you want me to drive?
No, all right? I just want you to shut up.
My little brother couldn't find his asshole with both hands. What makes you think he's gonna find us down here? Buzz has probably forgot all about you by now.
Maybe you're right. Maybe he's watching Hawaii Five-O without me.
I wonder what Steve McGarrett would do right now.
Who?
McGarrett. Jack Lord, Steve McGarrett, Hawaii Five-O, book 'em, Dano.
I don't get it.
I can't believe you don't know who McGarrett is. That doesn't surprise me. Forget it. It's just something me and Betty have.
You're a real stud, Turk. I could spend the rest of my life with someone like you.
Well, that's good. Because you try to run, and I'll cut your fucking head off.
Do you think your brother might actually harm your wife?
Absolutely not.
Oh, look out!
Thanks be to God, you got here in time.
You could have been killed.
Oh, we're all right. It's the other car.
Betty!
Buzz, wait!
The rest of us decided that the best thing to do was pray.
Okay.
You okay in there?
No, my leg's pinned in. I'm trapped. You gotta get me the hell out of here, man.
This whole area is a sacred site, you know.
Are you bleeding?
Yeah.
Where?
Damn it, Maya, get out of there. Go stand over there.
I'll call the rest of the sisters. Girls!
Bitch. Help! Get me out of here!
Everybody back!
Help! Come on, police, help me! Help!
Well, what are you waiting on?
Come on! Help me! Help! Please! Please, I'm in here! I'm in here! Please! I'm gonna die in here! Help me! Help me! Come on! Help!
Yeah. Don't worry. The sisters and I will take good care of him.
Okay. I kind of got my own emergency to
take care of right now.
Thank you, man.
Buzzard. Buzzard Wall. You have not given in to the temptation to ignore your fellow man. You have done well.
We shall all be praying for you.
Maya. Maya. Did you see that?
What?
Nothing.
Buzz.
You're wasting time. Let's go. Come on. What are you doing?
Get out.
What's going on?
We're walking.
How far?
You know, Betty, I liked you a hell of a lot better while you were asleep. About 6 miles by foot, and it's a border check by car. And I ain't too keen on that.
How do you know it's only 6 miles?
Trust me. Get a move on it.
Are you okay?
I don't feel so good.
Why don't you pull over and let me drive?
I'm fine, all right?
Pull the car over, Buzz.
I'll be all right. Just give me a minute.
Aren't you hot? Even at night, it must be a cool 102 out here. You're not still mad at me, are you?
For what?
You know, for not being more supportive back there. You're a loving person, Buzzard Wall.
Maya, wait a second. What are you? Maya, please stop. Maya! Oh. Maya, what has gotten into you?
You, Buzzard Wall. You've gotten into me before, and I want you into me again.
Maya, please. Maya, please. Please, Maya, don't. Stop. Please don't stop.
Give it to me, Buzz. Oh, come on, give it to me, Buzz. Oh. Do you remember this, Buzz? Oh, I do.
Oh, God. Maya, no. Please stop, Maya.
No, I can't stop.
Stop it.
Maya. I can't stop.
I can't do that to Betty. I can't do that. Not to Betty.
Huh? What?
Nothing. Just go back to sleep. Everything's all right.
Thank you.
you stopping?
Because they didn't go this way.
How do you know?
I just know.
Wait, please. I know I've been difficult, but I just want you to know one thing.
What, ma'am?
That if it comes down to it, and Betty or you get shot or maimed or killed, I promise that my story will be the one they use on CNN.
Wait here, I'm gonna take a piss.
Whatever you say, turd.
What'd you say?
I said, whatever you say, Turk.
She's still alive. Let's go.
What do we do now?
I'm gonna go in there and get my wife.
So you're just gonna waltz in there, grab Betty by the hand, wave a hello to Turk, and stroll out the door? That's a great plan, Buzz.
You got a better idea, little Miss Mary Hart.
Any of y'all know the way to Vegas? Yo, G.I. Joe, I asked you a question.
Like he ready for war or something.
Yeah. Yeah, we just left a chop shop.
Yo, dog.
A hot shopping spree in Warhead. And we looking to get to the casino. Ain't that right?
Us. These guys are criminals.
Exactly. And they're just what we need.
What are you doing?
How's it going there, brothers? I mean, fellas. If y'all are headed for Vegas, well, I know a way you can pick up a little extra gambling money if that would be all right.
What the hell is he talking about?
Man, that's sucker crazy.
Well, I'm just talking about pointing y'all in the direction of about $10,000.
Lead on, General.
Hey!
Don't even think about it, Betty.
Put a hole in you the size of New Orleans.
You're so romantic, Turk.
You're damn right.
Oh, for vase.
Fucking niggers must have got lost looking for a McDonald's.
Come on, come on, damn it.
Yo, dog, you gonna hang off my jock like some kind of bitch or something?
Yo, man, fuck you, motherfucker.
What you call me?
Motherfucker.
Fuck
yo, 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 man! It's between me and my boy, all
right? Not anymore, motherfucker. It's between you, me, and your boy, because you just did friends on my fucking game.
Apologize. Right now.
Yo, man, I'm sorry.
You're goddamn right you're sorry.
Right? I'm sorry. Where's the 10,000, motherfucker?
No one shoots no one in my sister's bar.
I love Mexicans.
You don't mean it.
I'm going in. You stay right here.
They said to give him at least 5 minutes. But...
5 minutes is too long. Now stay here.
It's your word.
Cabrons, we blow your stinking asses back to Los Angeles.
Well, I think we should just wait here for them.
Billy!
Buzzard!
Bring them out!
It's okay, Betty.
Well, 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 little brother. Got someone else to eat there to work for you. Just can't make a wildcat out of a pussy now, can you?
You never know, Turk. But I know one thing for sure. You can't make a pussy out of an asshole, you prison bitch faggot.
Thank you.
Rachel.
Dixon. Where do you want him?
Get him the hell out of here.
Get the hell out of here. Get him the hell out of here.
At ease, son. You, sir, are in the U.S.-Mexican FBI-DEA Joint Secret Underground Control Center, also known as a rat trap. Special Agent Floyd Kepner, K-E-P-N-E-R, at your service. We picked up Dixon on our surveillance cameras strategically planted in the desert. And I find it absolutely amazing that your brother is somehow smart enough to escape from prison and yet dumb enough to walk smack dab straight into our little web here.
How'd you know I was his brother?
All I'm at liberty to say is, we're in a lot of places these days. You'd be amazed all the things we know. In fact, if you knew any more, I'd probably have to kill you.
That stuff on your face there you call camo. Is that really 150 SPF all natural?
How'd you know that?
Well, like Agent Kepner said.
If you knew any more.
He'd have to kill you.
Anyway, we were just about ready to give our bartender operative the word that we were in fact ready to apprehend the said fugitive when you walked in and that trimmer hit.
Bill is supposed to be able to withstand that kind of pressure. I guess he's a little older than we thought.
It was quite a sight seeing the two of you tumble down through the roof like that.
Boom!
You are okay, aren't you, Mr. Wall? I mean, there's no need for a lawyer here, right? You didn't know, did you, Mr. Wall? When you're ready, I'll be outside to debrief you. Boys, let's give Mr. Wall a little privacy.
I'll be right there, baby.
Mr. and Mrs. Wall, you've both done an excellent job. Take care of everything else from here on out. You don't need to worry.
Mr. Dixon! Mr. Dixon, wait! I just want to ask you a few questions. How do you feel? Oh! Hey! Hey, come on! I just want to know how you felt about what happened here today.
Watch your head.
Mrs. Wall, I believe this belongs to you.
Thank you, Publishers Clearinghouse.
Mr. Kepner, I'd like this money to go to the family of the prison guard that my husband's brother killed.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's been a whole lot of trouble to us. I think we'd feel a whole lot better, wouldn't we, baby?
I love you.
You two change your mind, you just let me know. What is it, Mr. Wall?
Nothing. No. Nothing, sir.
Strange. This whole thing has been very strange.
Moderate train, just ahead on Capital Television, Maya Gunding. Talk about the terrific murder story she broke single-handedly almost 2 weeks ago.
They've shown parts of that story for over 2 weeks. It's disgusting.
I don't see why Maya just don't go right down there to that prison and marry Turk so she can continue her story.
Oh, God. Oh, I wish we had just a little of that publisher's clearinghurst money.
I'm sure you will. We'll be right back with Maya Gundinger.
Baby, I don't know what I'd do without you.
My buzz of baby, sweetie pie, cactus bugger, don't you cry. Betty's here to see you through. I'm gonna flip ya and fry ya and stand right by ya.
Come here, you hunk of baby making love. Coming, Bob!
Are you Wall?
That's right.
I'm Lieutenant Colonel J.P. McIntyre.
USMC.
We are very interested in you, son.
Well, ain't I just a little too old for you to be interested in me?
Not in you personally. In your product. War paint. Camo. We'd like an initial order of somewhere in the neighborhood of, let's say, 50,000 cases. Can you handle that?
Outstanding.
Now, if you'll just write down any reasonable figure right here in this block, and then sign your John Henry down there on the bottom of the contract, Mr. Wall, we'll be in business.
Buzz, what's going on?
Evening, ma'am. Now, there's no doubt in my military mind that the Quartermaster General of the United States Army is going to be knocking on your door here in the next few days. You just tell that old fart that he's a day late and a dollar short. The United States Marine Corps has landed, and the situation is well in hand. Tell him to queue up at the back of the goddamn line. Nice doing business with you. Keep your powder dry, Mr. Wall. Semper Fi. Okay, boys, saddle up. Mission accomplished. Let's head on back to Quantico.
Because you have to remember, you have to what? You have to what? You have to visualize to realize. And you have to what? You have to believe to achieve. As we all know, when the sun is hot, now it's not. How would you like to meet the creators of Camo? Buzz and Betty Wall and their new son, Buzz Jr. Come on now, here they are, look at them all. You and Buzz made in the last year and a half?
$10 million!
$10 million! $10 million! Can you believe it? Let's see what the baby thinks. How about you, Buzz Jr.?
camel.
Can you feel the power? Can you feel the power? That is another success story, ladies and gentlemen. And that's going to wrap us up. We're about out of time. This is Dan Gilmartin saying thank you from here in Hawaii. So let's give a nice Hawaiian sayonara. Ready? One, two, three.
Aloha!